long are people living? Well, data suggests that globally, life expectancy for males is around 66, and for females, it's around 71. In Australia, life expectancy for males is around 81, and for females, is around 85. In the USA, it's pretty similar, 77 for males and 82 for females. You can contrast that with Africa, where the average lifespan is around 30 years less for both men and women. That's mainly a result of HIV claiming lives, according to the World Health Organization. You can also see the population spread across the rest of the continents here, and some of how the lifespan is arranged across particular countries. But keep in mind that all countries are experiencing an aging of their population. Why are people in these particular decades, over 70 and particularly over 85, expanding as a percentage of the population? A lot of illnesses are age-related and affect people more later in life, particularly chronic diseases like heart problems, type 2 diabetes, or respiratory diseases. Thus, when new medical procedures or devices or techniques are developed, the people who are going to take most advantage of these technological breakthroughs are older people. Thus, people over age 75 are the fastest growing age group, not only in Australia, but in the developed and the developing world. These demographic shifts are already impacting our society. But it is important to realize that aging and your chances of getting older are not a simple linear phenomenon. For example, if you make it to age 60, then there are additional years of life you might expect, particularly if you live in a more developed country. This is because lots of children in the developing world still die before age 5. A lot of people worldwide have congenital conditions or diseases that shorten their lifespan. People in high-risk occupations are more likely to die young. So if you make it to age 60, then you actually have enhanced lifespan after that period of time because, in a sense, you found your way around these hurdles.